Hi, this is Megan Schweitzer with the National Weather Service Office in Flagstaff, Arizona, with an update to the winter weather outlook for the 2015-2016 season. This update is valid as of late October 2015. We are currently in a strong El Niño, seen here by very warm sea surface temperature anomalies across the equatorial Pacific Ocean, from near the dateline eastward to the South and Central American coastlines. This graphic shows sea surface temperatures over the past month or so. However, El Niño is classified by sea surface temperature anomalies averaged over a three-month period. The most recent three-month average from July, August, and September is 1.5 degrees Celsius, which classifies this as a strong El Niño. This is the third strongest El Niño on record up to this point through September, behind only 1987 in 1997. This El Niño is expected to peak with three-month average sea surface temperature anomalies near or above 2 degrees Celsius later this fall or early winter before subsiding sometime next spring. So what does this mean for our weather here in the Southwest? The warm ocean water in the eastern Pacific affects tropical weather patterns, which in turn affects mid-latitude weather patterns. During El Niño, we see an extended Pacific jet stream, or storm track, across the southern United States, while the polar jet stream remains farther north into Canada. This tends to bring wetter weather to the southern tier of the country, including Arizona. No two El Niños are exactly alike, but the presence of a strong one tilts the odds in favor of a wetter-than-average winter. Here's the updated winter outlook for December, January, and February. These take into account information from previous El Niño events, as well as climate model projections for the winter season. We see that odds favor a wetter-than-average winter across much of the southern United States, including Arizona. It's important to remember when looking at these outlooks that we're looking at a three-tiered probability. For example, a point near Flagstaff shows a 50% probability for a wet winter, 33% for a close-to-normal winter, and only 17% probability for a dry winter. If we combine the categories, results in an 83% chance that this winter will be near or wetter than normal. Here's the updated winter temperature outlook, which shows no strong signal toward warmer or cooler this winter. Data from previous El Niño events shows a strong tendency towards wetter winters across Arizona. Here's a look at the previous six strong El Niño events. In the center is a composite for fall and winter precipitation from all six events compared to normal. We see that northern Arizona received 120 to 160% of normal precipitation during the strong El Niños. Each of the individual seasons are shown along the bottom. All of the 6 years were wetter than normal for most of Arizona, though individual years varied substantially across the country. To put these six strong El Niño years into context, this chart shows how many of the 6 years ended among the wettest third of all years on record. For Arizona, all six of the previous strong El Niño years resulted in fall and winter precipitation amounts among the wettest third of all years on record. Although odds clearly favor a wetter winter, that doesn't always translate to more snowfall. Temperature and snow level variations from storm to storm make it difficult to predict winter snowfall on a seasonal timescale. And as we saw from the winter temperature outlook, we see equal chances for a warmer or cooler than average winter. However, we can look at previous El Niños to give us an idea of what to expect. Here we're looking at the average Flagstaff seasonal snowfall during all El Niños. On the right, we see that strong El Niños on average produce 134 inches of snow, which is roughly 32 inches above our average. Seasonal snowfall during the strong El Niño years has ranged from around 75 inches all the way up to our snowiest season ever of 210 inches in 1972 and 73. Of the six strong El Niños on record, four of the six produced above average snowfall in Flagstaff. So does that mean we can expect more snowy days this year? This table shows the average number of days with 2, 4, 6, or 8 inches of snow during a winter season, along with the frequency for each of the six strong El Niño winters. The average for the strong El Niño years is shown in red. We see an increase in the number of days with accumulating snow during strong El Niños, suggesting we can expect the same this year. To summarize the winter season outlook, we are currently in a strong El Nino that's expected to peak later this fall or winter. Odds favor a wetter than average winter due to the combination of climate model predictions and the influence from this strong El Nino. There's not a strong signal for warmer or cooler temperatures. Precipitation at several northern Arizona cities during past strong El Nino events does show a strong tendency for these years to be wetter than normal. This supports the official climate outlooks. Here are a few things to prepare for this winter. We can expect more frequent snowy days, leading to more frequent hazardous driving conditions. There will be an enhanced risk of ice dams forming on roofs, heavy snow loads, and increased wear on roads and highways. There's also a threat of high water in streams and rivers due to the wetter than average conditions anticipated. Be sure to check ready.gov to stay up to date with winter preparations, and also be sure to check our website at weather.gov/flagstaff to stay updated on the weather forecast throughout the winter season. Thanks for watching. We hope you enjoyed the video.